And welcome back. I'm the RPG Chick. We're headed back to First Fires. We need the Crucible Knights to, like, sponsor us to get us into this very important council meeting.
Perhaps a little rest is in order.
Oh. Well. We have stuff to do. We can rest after the council meeting. Oh, I hate that. I think we have to go talk to these... the Lord, whatever his name is, up here. Commander Cleaver. He smiles warmly. What may I do for you? I understand that the Crucible Knights are attending the Animancy hearings at the palace.
Indeed. Duke Avar looks to the Knights for prudent counsel as well as defense. I suspect our future as a city and a nation will depend in no small part on how we handle this matter.
Tell me about the hearings. He gives you a gruff frown. They're progressing slower than I'd like. The dozens raise a ruckus whenever anyone so much as mentions animancy, and the dominoes are obfuscating matters on purpose. Nevertheless, I'm confident Avar will see reason eventually. What do you think about animancy? Despite what happened with the Forge Knights, animancy merits further study in other contexts. There's much yet that animancers could do to cure soul maladies, strengthen essence, perhaps even ameliorate the effects of the legacy. He scratches his chin. We won't know until we try. We can't afford to sit on our hands while our rivals watch us grow weak. I need an audience with Duke Avar. I'd like to attend the meetings. And we'll be glad to have you with us. Avar will no doubt find your presence persuasive, and we need all possible support to see that he gives animancy a fair chance. Huh. Indeed or lie indeed. Instead of remaining somewhat ambivalent, I'll make sure he sees reason. Nope, nothing else you can do for me. Now that I'm formally invited to the Animancy hearings, I should return to Lady Webb and update her on my progress. I've been invited to join the Knights of the Crucible's delegation. Shouldn't I just go to the hearing? I have to run back and forth to this lady? And that's what I have to do, but still, I figure we just go to the meeting now and then talk to her. Yay. I feel like I'm almost as tired as my characters.
How fares your search?
Yeah, if I'm gonna do this for you, I think it's time you told me everything about Thais.
I've told you everything you need to know.
But not everything.
It's only right that you know everything. When I was younger, Before Dunreed Row, I had many suitors. These were fine-looking men of good stock, but I could see their thoughts, and they were unimpressive. Boys' thoughts. I toyed with their affections. I resented all of them. And then I met a man whose mind was a mystery to me. But he understood me. He knew me at a glance, told me things I didn't know about myself. He was neither handsome nor charming. He was all I ever wanted.
You're talking about Thais.
We made a game of my gift. He would ask me about people, and I would tell him what they were thinking. Sometimes the information was very sensitive. And then one day, he asked me if I trusted him. I said I did. Next I knew I was donning a silver mask and swearing oaths to Woodica. Using my gift for the leaden key still felt like a game to me, so I did it. I did it because it pleased him.
But it didn't last.
I don't like living in the dark. It's a powerless, hopeless feeling. Every day I did things without knowing their purpose. Every day I loved a man without knowing his thoughts of me. I sensed that there were things he wanted to tell me. I sensed that he knew everything the leaden key was created to hide. But Thais was unyielding. One day, I disappeared without a word. He would kill me for it, and I knew that. It's their rule. I just wanted to see him plunge the knife, because then I would know. But the day never came. He has left me to wonder. I have devoted my years to learning everything I could about him, in hopes I would find some clue as to who he really was and why he felt he had to keep his secrets locked away. I have precious little to show for it, just an old woman nagged by old thoughts. And that is truly everything I can tell you about Thais. I hope you will accept this embarrassing story as a show of my good faith. Yes?
I want to discuss the animancy hearings at the palace.
What of them?
The Knights of the Crucible have accepted me into their delegation.
Good. Avar Wolfgrin looks to the Crucible Knights as a voice of reason and order. Speaking from their section should lend you credibility with him. You need waste no more time here. Get to the palace. Make your case to the Duke. With him on our side, all of Dyrwood can be mobilized against the Leaden Key, and Thais can be rooted out. I only wish I could be there to see it. There is a very old bottle of a very good brandy that I have been saving for a special day. If you hurry back afterward, there may be a little left for you. Off with you. You're going to do very well in there.
So I'll take a look at number two, because it's highlighted, sort of.
What of them?
Oh, never mind. That's what I wanted to do in the first place, get to the hearings. We're hurrying.
I don't suppose we could rest a spell.
Well, we gotta get to this meeting, guy. going the right way? Yeah. That's the way in. A balcony has been reserved for you on... A place has been reserved for you on the balcony, Theodas. Go to the upper floor. Upper floor. How did he even know who we are? Who I am? We received word from Commander Cleaver that you would be attending, Theodas. The balcony has been opened for you. So that's Duke Eivor Wulfgren. The room below is animated amidst a heated debate. All the representative groups are easily discerned in the crowd. Crucible Knights, stiff in their noisy armor, sit in one section. In another are well-dressed members of House Domanel, casual, watching with a predator's interest. Still elsewhere are the ramshackle dozens who have made no special effort to dress up for their liege lord. Interspersed are animancers in their academics' robes, with expressions either sour or concerned.
Well then, answer me this, Master Barash. If you animancers represent our best hope to cure the legacy, what progress can you demonstrate?
At the back of the chamber sits the Duke, sprawled in his throne, worn down but alert and feisty nonetheless.
Ramir de Barask is originally from Palminia. He's one of the finest minds in Animancy to come out of the Valian Republics. He left for Defiance Bay 5 years ago, because he believed this was the true heart of Animancy research.
In Palagina's words and the way she looks at her countrymen, you sense both pride and a mild sense of frustration.
As I've said, it isn't about progress, it's about potential.
My house would agree, Your Grace. We see great potential in its future.
And I suppose your blazing profits during the legacy don't have nothing to do with that, do they, Domanel? You can't have it both ways, no more! Animancy goes, or this country goes!
So you admit, Master Barask, that Animancy is no closer to stopping the legacy than it ever was?
No, we've had many promising experiments. Cadman Azo has shown...
Cadman Azo murdered a child! For a complete failure! We should be hanging him right now for what he done! The dozens won't stand for it!
The experiment failed, yes, but his work...
His work was sabotaged.
Ah, our new delegate from the Knights of the Crucible. What makes you say sabotage?
All at once the attendees turn their faces toward you. A mishmash of judgment and incredulity. Only the Duke, a wild-looking man with a scraggly beard, seems unfazed by your interruption. I met a false patient in Brackenbury Sanitarium who had tampered with Azo's machinery.
The fuck's that even matter? Ooh. These are people who would toy with the lives of our children!
That's not really good language to be having in a court.
Indeed. Even assuming there was sabotage, is this Animancer Azo not still accountable here?
I like 1, 2, and 4. But I'm going to choose 1. This is not the bail of each incident. This is a responsible scientist who is manipulated. Aeloth whispers between gritted teeth. How can you call him responsible? You saw the state of the sanitarium.
Horseshit! These animancers can't be trusted! Look at what happened in Heritage Hill! our supposed protectors from Crucible Keep, can't even clean up the messes Animancy leaves!
Your Grace, we'd have a much easier time of it if our knights weren't so occupied trying to keep their organization from igniting a revolution on our very doorstep.
Heritage Hill is blood on your hands, Justiciar! You turn a blind eye, and look what happens!
I have been to Heritage Hill since the quarantine. Though the knights were unable to control the damage, it was not animancy, but an ancient machine that caused it.
You've some strange taste in travels, friend. The height of your tales expands with every breath.
Uh-huh. Chuckling at number four. My word is my oath. I challenge anyone here to find someone who knows different.
I had heard whispers of a new delegate set to attend today's hearing. I admit that your candor was mentioned more than once. Tell us what you saw in Heritage Hill.
Terra Nuneth houses an Ingwithin machine that holds dominion over the flow of souls. It was this machine that made the district undead. Kenna says, do you think that was the machine's purpose? Or just a dire side effect? He shudders. But then, why would the Ingwithins build such a machine after all?
Even if it is as you say, we have testimony that a group of animancers had been spending time there. Surely their tinkering had something to do with this.
Number one is a good point. I have reason to believe that there were others at the tower who might have done this.
Animancy has many enemies. You need only look around this room to see it.
You're missing the point! Everywhere there's animancers, there's disaster! We all know what Widewind's legacy's really about. And it ain't about some sparkling saint from Creed Saris who's mad because he took a stroll down the wrong bridge!
Creed Saris? Durin says, ha! Wrong bridge indeed.
It's about a bunch of so-called intellectuals fucking with the natural order while the rest of us gotta suffer for it!
Is it, though? Should we not take the time to reach a clear conclusion? I mean, what proof do we have?
My son and daughter are buried beneath the floor of my house. We don't own no land, so that's where we lay them. My son. My wife let him slip when she was bathing him. Got water in his lungs he couldn't cough up. My daughter? We put her to bed one night, and the next morning she wasn't breathing. This hollowborn thing? It ain't ending. And it ain't ending because we still let these charlatans play God. There's your proof, you damn copper fucker!
Enough, Adric. Lady Dominel makes a point. If it's animancy, then why do the other states that permit the practice not suffer the same fate? Who among us can say he truly understands why the legacy has taken hold here?
I can. The crowd begins to mutter, the sound taking a doubtful character. Durin says, right idea, Watcher. Taking this hearing by the curly ones. Don't waste your chance. Widewind's legacy is the creation of the Leaden Key. Cadman Azo's downfall was their work, as was the tower in Heritage Hill. They want you to do this. They want animancy to fall. The dull muttering expands into a din of skepticism that fills the hall. I have seen them in the ruins of Erglanfath, operating machines that disrupt and redirect the flow of souls, near towns like Gilded Vale and Deerford, where the legacy is universal. As a watcher, I have heard their dead confess their plot. They are stealing the souls of the unborn.
Beasts. Another lunatic at the hearing. Did you remember to lock your sanitarium before you left, Master Barask?
The room laughs. Well, you heard it. Ooh, you want to see crazy? I like that. Number five. I don't want to stoop to her level. You shame your order by dismissing the truth before hearing it, madam. I expected better from a knight of the Crucible.
You must know, friend, that the Leaden Key is a mantle for small-time ruffians and children at play. I'm not saying you're a liar. Not yet. But you'd better start making sense of all this. Help us believe you.
The Duke leans forward in his throne, a trace of curiosity in his eyes. Some interesting choices. What's more likely? That the gods are destroying Dyrwood for a science practiced in many parts of the world? Or that a group of people hates animancy and wants it suppressed? Oh, he's not yelling. Edric yells, "Another guess! Throw her out on her ass, Your Grace. She's wasting our time." Mechanics. This is no guess. I have seen these people carry out their missions in the ruins of Ir Glanfath. So, I guess in these scripted events, because, Durance easily has more than Mechanics 5.
The Justiciar's right! This is sanitarium talk!
You've made an unexpected case, friend. I'll say that much. It seems we have a new possibility to consider, at the very least. How was it you came to learn all this?
Interesting. How are they gonna take that, the Knights of the Crucible? Instrumental. Hey, were they instrumental? No more so than anyone else, I guess. I took a personal interest in the matter and tried to learn what I could.
Indeed. This land is foreign to you, unless I miss my guess. Your efforts on its behalf are to be commended.
The Duke raises his eyebrows.
But these hearings are about more than Wydwin's legacy, even though that is our most pressing concern. Let's say for the moment that I were to take you at your word that our friends in Brackenberry Sanitarium and their peers bear no responsibility for this curse upon my country. I'm curious, what would you do if you were in my position?
Interesting question. So, easily a scale between completely accepting and then going down to completely not accepting. I think animancy should be studied in Dyrwood. If you don't, someone else will, and they will wield great power over you. It's true. Her face still, Pelagina looks your way and subtly nods in approval. Alosh shakes his head. Animancers serve their own ambitions and their own purses. Giving them this power is like setting a child loose in an armory.
Very well. That is all I wish to hear. Not just from you, but from everyone. Many days we've been at this. It is time we put it to rest. I want to thank the delegations for helping me collect my thoughts. And our new delegate, who has warned us of a new possibility that must be looked into. The time has come to choose a direction for the Dyrwood. I am ready to make my pronouncement. Ramir de Barash, representing the interests of Animancers in Dyrwood, step forward.
Your Grace.
What?
It occurs to me now that my concerns about Animancy may not outweigh its value.
What?
Forgive me, Your Grace. We will accept no judgment but our own.
What's he doing?
No! Avenge you!
No, no, wait!
Stop this, at once!
Yeah!
Wow. Designed to fail.
I've given you every chance to end this pursuit. Shall I end it for you? Another time. I am already late.
Time for a nap.
She says time for a nap because we need to rest. The words, "Shall I end it for you?" ring in your ears. You find yourself gasping for breath, struggling to keep your own balance. You drop to a knee and watch as Theus hurries out of the building. The world dims around you, the screams and clashing of weapons fading to silence. All that remains are the words.
Shall I end it for you?
Theus stands at a pulpit high above an assembly of robed onlookers, you among them, clustered around a wide circular pit carved of stone. He addresses a woman bound backward over a large iron wheel overlooking the great stone maw. Many of the woman's fingers and toes are severed, and the bottoms of her feet are charred black. The skin on one side of her face looks like melted candle wax, black and red and seeping, and the angle of her back suggests a spine in ruins. Yet for all that, her expression betrays little of her anguish.
I am already at peace, Grand Inquisitor. Are you?
Her eyes are barely open, and her words come between strangled breaths, but they are steady, unbroken.
So be it. If you desire no end, you shall have none. I find you guilty of heresy. May the eternal prison bar your soul from passage, for it is beyond redemption.
Theodos was granted dominion of the sleepers? He nods to a hooded attendant who begins untying her from the wheel. You open your eyes to the beam ceiling of the palace's grand entry hall. The clangs of metal striking metal waft in from outside, alongside the cries of the injured as you stagger to your feet. Theos is gone. Pelagina is standing over you, her eyes darting around the room before looking down and thrusting her hand out to grab yours. Her eyes glow with an inner light, her voice taking on an otherworldly timbre. Get up! Now! Off to one side you can hear the clinking rustle of chainmail, and you look over to see a wounded guard slumped against the wall. He is trying to say something, seemingly directed at you, but at first is too faint to hear. He gathers his breath and manages to rasp out a few words. Lady Webb, she's the only... She must be told. She'll know what to do. Please, find her. Tell her everything. The guard passes out and slides to the floor, still.
Keeping an eye out.
Is this combat time? Don't go out there. There's rioting in the streets. I don't remember closing that. So what's your name in her temple?
How do you do?
She has no idea about anything. The rioters will be upon us soon. Get out while you can. Alright guys, we're gonna leave. We're gonna save it for next episode. My guess is there's gonna be fights with rioters. We have to make our way back to Lady Webb. It was very, very interesting. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. Endure. And enduring, grow strong.